Okay, you guys, we were working on these skill exercises and I was answering questions in class today, and I basically taught myself a really good way of understanding how to get these alphas and figure out KI from the different types of double reciprocal plots. So let's just talk a little bit about the different types of inhibition and how that affects the plots real briefly. For competitive inhibition, your Vmax doesn't change and your apparent KM increases. In other words, the inhibitor binds only to the free enzyme with an inhibition constant called KI. And when you look at the Lineweaver-Burk plot, here's what you see. The 1 over Vmax stays the same, meaning they have the same Vmax, and the slope changes. The slope is alpha KM over Vmax. What does that mean? It means that when alpha is 1, that's no inhibitor, the slope is just Km over Vmax. And when you add inhibitor, alpha increases. What you just then need to do is find the slope of the line with the inhibitor, that's alpha Km over Vmax, then divide it by the slope without inhibitor, and the Km over Vmax cancels out, and you have alpha. Boom, it's done. So dividing the slopes gives you alpha for competitive inhibition. Now let's look at uncompetitive. For uncompetitive, both Km and Vmax decrease, but the Km over Vmax doesn't change, and so the lines are parallel. Uncompetitive means that the inhibitor only binds to the enzyme substrate complex, not to the free enzyme. So here the slopes are the same. So you cannot use the slopes to determine anything, but you can in fact use the Y-intercept. The Y-intercept is alpha prime over Vmax. So if I look at the Y-intercept for the uninhibited, that's 1 over Vmax, that's here. The inhibited one is alpha prime over Vmax, so I literally just divide the two Y-intercepts, the 1 over Vmaxes cancel out, and I get alpha prime. It's that simple. So for the competitive, I divide the slopes, I get alpha. For the uncompetitive, I divide the y-intercepts and I get alpha prime. What about mixed? Well, mixed is just a combination of competitive, where the enzyme binds the inhibitor when it's free enzyme, or uncompetitive, when the enzyme substrate complex binds the inhibitor. And so you get a KI and a KI prime, and you just can do the same things. So in this case, you can divide the slopes to get, sorry, not that one. You can divide the slopes, which aren't shown here, they're shown here, to get alpha. And you can divide the y-intercepts to get alpha prime, and it's that simple. In the case of mixed, then you have two different KIs, the KI for binding to the free enzyme, and the KI prime for binding to the enzyme substrate complex. If those bindings are equivalent, then you have non-competitive inhibition when the binding is exactly the same to both. And that plot looks like this, where the KMs stay the same. Now, what I didn't talk about in this little video is that you can also use the X-intercepts to figure out alphas, because when I go back and look at the different types of inhibition, the X-intercept is 1 over alpha times Km. So if I divide X-intercepts, I will get 1 over alpha in this case. And in this case, when I divide X-intercepts, I'll get alpha prime. But you don't need to do, since your equation comes out in the form y equals the slope times x plus the intercept, and since I just showed you how you can do everything by dividing both the y-intercepts to get the alpha prime, or dividing the slopes to get the alpha, that's the simple way to get either of them. Once you have alpha or alpha prime, then you just plug it into the equation. So when we look at the different types of inhibition and equations for those, this is what we did last Friday in our card sort activity. But here are the equations for inhibitor. And look, it's alpha equals 1 plus inhibitor concentration over KI, or alpha prime equals 1 plus the inhibitor concentration over Ki prime. That's all there is to it. So if you have an alpha prime, you use this equation. If you have an alpha, you use this equation. And whichever units you put in for the inhibitor concentration, that's what units you'll get out with the Ki, because those units cancel out in the fraction. So that's how you figure out the Ki or the Ki prime. If your inhibition is competitive, you only have a Ki because the inhibitor only binds to the free enzyme. If your inhibition is uncompetitive, you only have a Ki prime because your inhibitor binds only to the enzyme substrate complex. And what do those things tell you about the structure of the inhibitor? If it binds to the free enzyme and it's competitive, it's binding into the active site, so that tells you that it's probably similar in structure or shape to the substrate. If it's binding only to the enzyme substrate complex, it's probably not similar to the structure of the substrate. And then you have mixed. And mixed is when you have the inhibitor binding to both, so you have both a Ki and a Ki prime. If those turn out to be equivalent to each other, which says that the inhibitor binds equally well to the free enzyme or the ES complex, then you have non-competitive, which looks like this. And the Ki and the Ki prime are the same, and the alpha prime are the same. If you end up with mixed, you can therefore calculate either a Ki or a Ki prime or both. And on this skill exercise, if that's what you end up with, I don't care which one you do, or if you do both, kudos for you. So this is a good way to determine the alpha from your equations of straight lines, and the Ki or Ki prime, and I hope it's been helpful. Cheers.